Hi, I'm Beth with 50 Plus Beauty, and I'm excited that you're here with me today for this special edition of 50 Plus Beauty, where I get a little more personal, where I talk about my New Year's resolutions for 2019. Ladies, isn't it just amazing that we're already at 2019? It is amazing, especially in the second half, how fast life seems to start moving. So, girls, let's just get on that train. Let's keep moving with it. Let's keep our goals flowing. Let's keep our objectives going, because our second half is a wonderful time of life where we take everything that we learned in the first half, all those hard-fought lessons that we learned, and roll them up in a big ball and use them to create a fabulous second half for ourselves that benefits us and benefits everyone around us. If you're also in your second half and you're interested in having your best life possible from here on out, then I hope you'll consider subscribing. And when you click that little bell, that just notifies you of my twice weekly videos. And if you could give this video a thumbs up, that would help me too. So let's get down to this, and I'll share with you my resolutions for 2019. And I almost hesitate to call them resolutions because those are easy not to keep. Let's just call them goals and objectives for 2019. And in thinking about my objectives for 2019, I had to take a more long-term approach. That is one thing that us in the second half, we realize, is that we really can't take a short-term approach. Maybe we did that in our 20s and 30s and learned some lessons from that. It's really better in life to take a more long-term approach, to say, go 35 years out in my case, and at 35, since I am 60, I will be 95 years old. And it's important for us to take a look at the long-term plan, to look at where we want to be at, say, 95, and work backwards. So the question is, what do I want my life to look like if I make it to 95, which God willing and permitting I will? And here is how I want my age 95 to look. At 95, I want to be trim and healthy and take no medications if possible. I see some older people in my family and they're on like 12 medications each, and I really don't want to go there if I don't have to. Okay, since a vibrant and healthy 95 is my objective, let's take a look at the things I can do right now to help achieve that. The first is I can drink more water, and I have some water right here. This is room temperature water because it's a little easier to get more of this down. And I've decided this year to replace the Diet Pop that I've been drinking, which, girls, I have been sort of addicted to Diet Dr. Peppers. In 2019, I want to replace all that Diet Pop and those artificial sweetener-laden beverages with water, because the more water we drink, the more lubricated our joints are, the better our skin looks. Water is just very good for us. Another objective is to stay on my low-carb diet. This time I've been following the keto diet, which has been working very well for me. In fact, very soon I'll be posting a video about how I gained a little weight and how I used the keto diet to lose that 5 pounds that I had gained. And in addition to that, I just feel better on low-carb, where I'm really not eating those cakes, pies, cookies, breads, rice, potatoes, where I'm really focusing on good quality fats and high quality proteins with a little bit of vegetables on the side. So that is definitely an objective, to stay on that low carb diet. And in terms of my 95 year old ideal self, I do not want to have diabetes like several people in my family do. So I really want to stay low carb, because that keeps your blood sugar nice and stable. And again, looking at my 95 year old ideal self, I want to be trim, flexible, and strong. And the way to do that is to get movement every single day. And I've decided that I'm going to make working out a priority in 2019. I did work out in 2018, but I kind of let it be a little more sporadic. And in 2019, I really just want to make it a non-negotiable. Here is how I handled working out in the past year. And I always work out in the morning because that's when I have the energy to do it. If I wait till after work, 9 times out of 10, I just won't do it. So here is what I've done up till now. I always set the alarm for 5 o'clock, and I would get up at 5 o'clock, but before doing my workouts, I would do my prayer, my meditation, my little bit of reading, and then I would get to working out, which in some cases, if I would start to read a really interesting book, I just never would go downstairs and do my workouts. So this time I've realized that one of the first things I do when I get up is that I need to go ahead and get that workout out of the way. So that's what I'm resolving to do in 2019, is that when I get up at 5 o'clock each morning, at least of the workday, 5 days a week, I'm going to get up, brush my teeth, put in my contacts, and then I'm going to go right downstairs and do my workouts. And I've been doing a 20-minute Tai Bo DVD, and I've just been doing the beginner one, but I've been doing it for years, and I really, really like that. And then I spend 20 minutes on my elliptical. And in both cases, what I do to make it enjoyable is I put on my YouTube videos and I put the DVD sound a little lower than my YouTube videos. So as I'm doing my Tai Bo with old Billy Blanks, I'm going ahead and listening to my YouTube videos too, so it makes it a pleasant experience. But that's what I plan to do in 2019 to make working out a priority by doing it the first thing. And when I look ahead at my 95-year-old self, she also has certain emotional and spiritual qualities. Number one, she's a great God follower. She reads the Bible. She goes to church. She has a good support group in her church, which I do now, and I hope to nurture those relationships so when I'm 95, I still have a good church group. Also, my 95-year-old self is just a grateful person. She's a glass half full type of person. And that is one little flaw that I've had in the past is that I tend to be kind of a perfectionist. And so I think, well, when I get to that, I'll be happy. Or when I do this, I'll be happy. And you know, life is too short not to be happy right now. Whenever I start to go negative, I'll just say stop and say, thank you, God, for the great gifts of my world. Thank you, God, for the great gifts of my world. And that's something I've really learned, and you've heard it a million times before, but in my world, I believe that God does not give bad gifts. So either it's an outward gift that I realize the beauty of it in that exact same moment, or it's a learning gift where I won't realize the true nature of the gift till down the road. But thank you, God. I know you give great gifts, and I stand here with open arms ready to accept them. Well, friends, that was a look at my New Year's resolutions for 2019, and if you haven't made yours yet, I hope you'll look at your idealized self at 90 or 95 years old and work backward and see what you need to do right now to help achieve that. And if you're not a subscriber and you're interested in making your second half your best half in body, mind, and spirit, then I hope you'll consider subscribing, and when you click that little bell, that just notifies you of my future videos, and I hope you'll give this video a thumbs up too. Okay, I always like to leave you with a little thought for the day, and I'm going to be interested in what the language of letting go tells us today, since this is about New Year's resolutions. We'll see if we get a card that can kind of, in some way, shape, or form, relate to that. Here we go. Ooh, that's a good one. Learning discipline. Learning discipline. I guess that's important with regard to goals, is to be disciplined. Today, I will surrender to discipline. I realize that sometimes it takes time to see the fruits of my labors, yet I still need to practice discipline. God, help me to remember that I'm moving forward and that I'm learning the very important art of discipline. Oh, friends, this is interesting that I got this today, and actually it makes a lot of sense to me because really in terms of those goals that we all have, one of the most important things is to have discipline and realize that sometimes we may not feel like getting up at 5 and doing that workout first. We may not feel like working out at all, but through discipline, through actually doing those things that we may not want to do in that exact same moment and realizing that it's a non-negotiable, that we just need to have the discipline to do it, we can start to accomplish some of those goals and objectives that we have for ourselves and have an even better second half. Take care. See you next time.